Hey guys, I'm Sakura and I'm one of the co-founders of Vlogette. Today I'm going to show you guys all about the cloning tool in Photoshop. So the cloning tool is actually by far my favorite tool of all times in Photoshop, which is a big deal for me to say, but really it is because it just allows you to do so much. So I'm going to show you guys really the basic of it, and then you can always expand so much more. So here I am in Photoshop right now, and see that again. Perfect. So as you can see here, this is a photo that we took for our Instagram. And if you guys can see, there is a little typo on the chalkboard, which is a big no-no, and we don't want to post that on Instagram. So what I'm going to do is use a cloning tool to remove it. Now, eraser sounds like the perfect tool for you, but you don't want to erase it because that means you're going to erase your entire picture, that portion. So you don't want to erase it, you want to clone it. So let me show you guys right here. So here's a cloning tool. As you can see, it works like it's a brush. So you can select the type of brush, if it's a hard brush, the size of it. It works just like a regular brush tool in Photoshop. Now, when you're blending things in, which majority of the time you are blending things in when you're using the cloning tool, you want to use the soft brush. Soft brush just allows you to really blend it in. It's not a hard brush, so you can't see the edge of your brush. So use a soft brush for sure. So you can see, here's a soft brush, here's a hard brush. That's the difference between the two. So keep it soft. And then as far as your brush size goes, you can see it following me right now. You want it to be not too small, not too big. You want to keep it up at a perfect medium size. So it depends on what you're cloning, but this is a decent size for what I'm trying to clone. It says beauty, not beauty, so we're going to clone that out. So opacity and flow, the more you play around with the cloning tool and Photoshop, the brush, you will get more familiar with the opacity and the flow. Opacity is basically how transparent you want it to be. If you want it to fade in a little bit, you can lower the opacity. The flow is the speed of it. So if you really want to blend things in, you want to keep your flow and your opacity kind of low. But for this, we want to clone exactly the chalkboard texture over beauty. So we want to keep the opacity at 100. So I'm going to hold option, okay? The second you hold option on your keyboard, you'll see that your cursor will change into a target. So what you're going to do is you're going to hold option and click right outside of the area that you want to clone. So hold option, click, and you'll see that it is starting to go away. And you'll see that where my circle is where I'm cloning. You'll see a little cross mark, and that's where I'm cloning from. So remember to keep an eye on that. So you'll have to do it a couple times to get rid of all this. So hold option again, click, and then just brush. And you'll see that I'm using my Wacom tablet pen. Here's the tablet. It just makes it really easy for me to draw, erase, write things. So I love my Wacom tablet. You should definitely invest in one if you're going to do Photoshop a lot. But let's do it again. So hold option, click, and you can just get rid of it. Now it's a chalkboard texture, so maybe you want to grab it from this side. You can do whatever you want. But again, you want to blend it in, so you want to be within the area so you can blend out whatever it is you're cloning. Okay, let's get rid of this right here. And then perhaps you wanna clone over the line. So I'm gonna clone target, hold option, click, and then look at that. Now it just says blog. So the cloning tool can do so much more. If there's like a little spot on your shirt that you want to remove, or if there's a ugly trash can in the beautiful photo that you just took, you can really clone out everything and anything. It'll just take a little bit of practice and you will be perfect at it. Let me just go into this example right here. Say I wanted to get rid of all these dots on the concrete wall. You can easily do so by, again, holding option, click, holding option, click. So now there's no distraction at all in this photo. It's really such a powerful tool and you can do so much. You can get rid of blemishes on your skin, whatever it is, but it's my favorite tool for sure. And I hope you enjoy this video. And if you guys have any questions, comment below. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and give this video a thumbs up. Thanks guys, bye.